Well, that was something.
Is there anything to the theory, Bugs?
Oh no, she's off her fucking lid for sure. Allegedly, her shadowy cabal is headquartered at a nearby Albion field office. Might be worth investigating regardless.
Sounds like a plan. Let's infiltrate a shadowy cabal.
Someone else, yeah? You won't catch me doing shit.
Take it easy.
All right, sorry about that. Albion's been fucking with me all day. Thought you were one of them.
Crying about it won't fix anything. Tell me what's wrong and maybe we can help.
I must have done something to piss them off, because every time I go for a checkpoint now, they're all up my arse. Or someone is using CTOS to send in false reports about me.
Could be. Is there anyone who'd want to mess with you like that?
People don't exactly get all wet when I come around. I have lots of enemies. Care to snoop around in the system for me? See what people are saying? Help me with this, and I'll make it worth your while, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, all right. I'll rally the comrades.
Clearly understand. Yeah. Only fool.
Any ideas?
We have a CTOS backdoor already, but all the reports are anonymized. If you want to know who's targeting our friend, get me a hard line into a government server.
All right, let's get some data. Send me those location deets. Oi, Bags, check this one. We could get our own medic.
It's better than watching tutorials on how to suture your own wounds.
Watch where you're going. So,
please, for God.
This asshole.
He's a shady character, that's for sure. His network activity shows he's been trying to hack the National Health Service.
Fuck me. The NHS is on its last legs as it is. Last thing it needs is some hacker trying to sabotage it.
You're right. What if he injected some easily deletable code or opened an easily closable back door? Blimey, it might take me seconds to fix. Come on, just connect me to a hospital server and I'll sort it.
Will do.
I'm Tash, and you're listening to Buccaneer, your source for what they don't want you to know. Today we're talking about Dev Hassani, our gone, but sadly not forgotten, Prime Minister. It's strange to think that he was just another here-today, gone-tomorrow politician until his infamous London is drowning speech went viral. The forces of darkness he unleashed with that speech changed everything around us. Was Hassani's rise inevitable? Could it have been stopped? And what happens when democracy starts to breathe the ideas that can destroy it? Using back channels and underground content, we got in touch with political analysts and historians to find out how it's possible for cynical, short-term leaders like our beloved Prime Minister to give birth to political nightmares. No full names, as you know. These days, telling the truth can get you killed. Helen spelt out the dangers of populism for major political magazines and websites back in the pre-censorship
days. Autodrive now disabled.
Fascist politics is about strongmen, and they are usually men, because it's about saying there are simple problems that are really easy to define, say immigration, and there are simple solutions to them. Stop immigration. And they are in your opinion.
Is London Calling. I'm Tash, and you're listening to Buccaneer, your source for what they don't want you to know. Today we're talking about Dev Hassani, our gone, but sadly not forgotten, Prime Minister. It's strange to think that he was just another here today, gone tomorrow politician.
Until his infamous London Downing speech went viral.
The thing you're after is around here.
And what happens when democracy starts to bring the idea to destroy it? Using back channels and underground content, we've got in touch with political analyst Andy Claudio to find out how it processes the cynical short-term leaders like our beloved Prime Minister to give birth to political nightmares. Local names, as you know. Helen spells out the dangers of populism for major political magazines and websites. That's in its consensus. You hear a bunch of politics about strongmen, and they are usually men. Because it's about saying they are
looking to get friendly, are ya?
Shut up! Are you a few
sandwiches short of a picnic? You're standing too close. Back up a bit, yeah?
Hey, you look like a fighter without a cause. Am I reading you right?
Fuck me! Are you dead sick? I could use your help.
We'll try, and that's more than most. What's going?
I brought my friend into this group, yeah? Protesting Albion and all that. Well, fuck! At the last protest, Albion turned up the heat and beat up my friend. They got carted away in an ambulance. Well, word is they're dead now. But the cunts won't let anybody see the body.
That's awful. I'm sorry.
Something smells off about the whole thing. I want answers. If you can find out if my friends, if they're dead or not, I'd owe ya.
This could be serious. We'll take care of it. You look like someone who wants to get out there and make a difference. Are you saying you're with DedSec? I know people. Let's leave it at that. Fuck yes.
Can I leave a DedSec was here tag?
There it is. You can hack in from there.
You need
Time to pick up where your teammate left off. I'm sure they'll thank you once they stop eating through a tube.
Well, it was for a good cause. And now I'm up.
You're in. Now find the thing. Tracing the Spider-Bot's serial number, it was assigned to New Scotland Yard 3 years ago. Perhaps more information about its user or its assignment will be available at the station.
It's hard to believe the police may have known who the real bombers were all along and never said anything to the public.
The only way to know for sure is to investigate New Scotland Yard.
Is London calling? I'm Tash, and you're listening to Buccaneer, your source for what they don't want you to know. Today we're talking about Dev Hassani, our gone, but sadly not forgotten Prime Minister. It's strange to think that he was just another here today, gone tomorrow politician until his infamous London is drowning speech went viral. The forces of darkness he unleashed with that speech changed everything around us. Was Hassani's rise inevitable? Could it have been stopped? And what happens when democracy starts to breed the ideas that can destroy it? Using back channels and underground contacts, we got in touch with political analysts and historians to find out how it's possible for cynical short-term leaders like our beloved Prime Minister to give birth to political nightmares. No full names.
This is the right location. Located the CTOS hub.
my business.
Clan Kelly has our friend ID'd as a highly dangerous vigilante. She's been single-handedly raiding properties run by Clan Kelly and hospitalizing whoever's in charge.
Sounds like our kind of people. Let's recruit her.
Tracking her optic. Looks like she's off to raid another compound at these coordinates.
Let's see our vigilante in action. I'm here.
No sign of our vigilante anywhere in the area.
Let's start asking around. Somebody must have seen something. This place needs some character. That'll keep food on the table.
Now there's a statement. The whole borough of Southwark will see this and know someone is sticking it to Albion. I like the direction you took with this one.
Thanks, Bags.
Hey, fuck you now, that was mental. Boss girl runs in now, lays waste to them gangsters, left, right, centre, bro. Total badass. Fought like a beast until they knocked her out and took her in there.
Shit. She needs us.
Boss girl could use a little something, innit? Them gangsters don't fuck around, blood. Hate to be her right now, that's all I'm saying.
Sounds like she bit off more than she could chew.
If we help her, she might join up. We should do it.
Oh! Investigating disturbance.
That's her. Get her out of here. Get her out.
Looks like you avoided them.
Are you okay? That was a close one. I completely understand. Being the hero feels great, I know. But you get a lot more done when you've got backup. Honestly, you're lucky to be alive. It's funny. The first time out, I did it because I felt hopeless. Like I had nothing to lose, so I might as well kick up a storm. But doing it actually made me feel better. Made me feel like I was in control of my life again. Not a victim. There's no going back. I'm not going to be helpless again.
Hey, you know what? You're exactly the kind of person DedSec is looking for. You should join us. It's fun.
Hell yes. I'm in.
What is this shit?
That thing is acting.
The friend's official record states he was taken to hospital before he died.
We should look into it.
Are you interested in helping London?
Fuck me! Are you dead sick? I could use your help.
We'll do our best to help out. What's your problem?
I've got a mate with a rare genetic disorder. Need special drugs, but the NHS is so fucked, they can't get any. A Clan Kelly doctor offered help, though. It was an experimental treatment, but we had no other options, so I paid him.
Go on.
The drugs were working at first, but they were addictive. The doctor jacked up the price when my friend got hooked. We fell right into a trap.
That's just so inhumane. Don't worry about it. We'll get your friend's meds.
Someone's
You're at the hospital where our prospect's friend died. We can get hold of his full patient record here.
I understand.
Located the CTOS hub. Well, our prospect should be pleased. Turns out her friend isn't dead. Or if he is, he didn't die here.
What do you mean?
There are no patient records on file, and GPS data shows the ambulance going dark before it reaches the hospital. The driver must have switched it off. I'm upgrading this from dodgy to fucking dodgy.
I'm on it.
You won't have to look very far. The driver is on site now.
Trespassing is kind of fun. Sending you the data.
Good. I'll do some fancy maths on it while you escape from this weirdly dangerous hospital.
What have you found, Bagley?
I've cross-referenced the driver's location history with the missing GPS data from his ambulance. Looks like he dumped his patient at an SIRS facility.
Fascinating.
Deep state creeps like SIRS tend not to interrogate corpses. If our missing person is in their custody, he's probably still alive.
Let's see what I can find. I'm here.
So's our missing person. Seems this is where everyone on the SIRS naughty list winds up. Expect heavy security.
What am I getting myself into?
Friend's just been taken into Albion custody. So long as you don't cock up that badly, you'll be my favorite operative today.
That's a shame, but we've got a job to do.
This is the place. Our man's in here.
Units, proceed to alarm location. Acknowledge, over.
Get him out of here.
Live alarm. I repeat, live alarm. Location sent. Need a 10-13.
Set that alarm off. Let's take a look.
See anyone following you?
I have amazing news. Your friend is alive. Sirs had them, but we took care of that.
Oh my god. I thought I was being delusional for holding out hope. Thank you. Seriously, I don't know how I'll repay you.
You know how you could help? Join us. Be a part of DedSec.
Fuck yeah. Sign me up.
Boy, what's your fucking problem? Oi, big man.
I ain't looking for trouble.
Get down, do you?
Not
you're
again.
Shit out of luck. You're on Clan Kelly Torf now, all right? There's no fucking trouble for you here. Piss off.
Still during the scan.
Come with me.
No, hold on. There's been some kind of mistake.
Shut up. You're under arrest.
Oh.